The decision to investigate Uganda Netball Federation President Babidi Chityo comes after the Auditor General of Government, John Muwanga, found loopholes in the recent accountability for 186 million by the Uganda Netball Federation from the 2021 Netball Penty Series and the African Netball Championship. And then we'll have our chairman. National Council of Sports procured tickets for the traveling contingent, which was not reflected in the Uganda Netball Federation accountability to the Auditor General of Government, and NCS later found out from Namibia Netball Federation that the Namibia had funded the Penty Series trip 100%.
Indicating that the Federation defrauded the government of Uganda falsely, and got money falsely, well aware that the government of Namibia had taken full board expense for 17 members of the contingent in Namibia. Actually, this is one of the biggest problems of the Federation that was identified, and the details has been forwarded to CID.
When Babidi Kityo, the Uganda Netball Federation president, was contacted on phone, she denied the allegations.
We said Namibia was fully funded.
Yeah, by the government of Namibia.
By the Namibian
Penty Series, yes.
So how did he then procure tickets for a fully funded tournament?
And they claim they got to understand it after giving you the funds.
Fine. Did he give, because he didn't give me that fund. He didn't give me funds for tickets. He procured the tickets.
He procured the ticket and the 186 for you to cater for other things.
No accommodation.
What?
No problem. I also, his doctored document, I have it and I want us to go through it. Now, when you say you didn't know it was fully funded by Namibian government, Namibia has a government still. They are not at war. I can give you the letter, rather the contact for the Namibian General Secretary to tell you who was she working with. First of all, she was working with Amina Man, who was the General Secretary then. But I want to conclude with that story. But let us first go through this. If Dr. Gwell is saying he gave me 186 million and the trip was fully funded, in Namibia we had two tournaments.
Yeah.
We had Penty Series.
And the African Netball Championship.
So was all this money meant for Penty Series?
Yeah, that in his statement, that's what he claims.
Good. Then what happened to the Africa Championship?
I know both events, that the 186 million was for both.
So both events were fully funded.
Both events were fully funded by the government of Namibia.
Fine. Then if you want to confirm that, I'll give you the contact of the president of Namibia, the president of Zimbabwe, the president of Kenya, the president of Tanzania, the president of Namibia, the president of South Africa, and on top of that, I'll give you the invitations. There is no way all these countries can connive to help Uganda embezzle 186 million. We're journalists, find out from our neighbors in Kenya, from Tanzania, from these other countries. Were these tournaments fully funded?
Recently, several sports federation leaders have been accusing Dr. Patrick Ogwell for asking for bribes.
The statements has made over the matter of allegation of bribe. This matter has already been referred to CID for investigation. And we are requiring her, now that she has refused to give you the evidence, she will provide this evidence in court. I've already registered that matter at a personal level. A case of defamation has been opened.
National Council of Sports chairman confirmed that they have money to help the netball Shikrins and the tactical team preparing for the World Cup in South Africa later this year, but that money will not go through the channels of the Ghana Netball Federation, who are facing charges of misappropriating government funds.
We reach out in 60 days. We must be able, as council, to account to the other organs of government. So a federation that does not account cannot continue to receive other monies when they have not fully accounted for what they have received. As a matter of fact, we have money on account to help netball, even right now, even in the situation that we're in where there's no match, because we know we have World Cup upon us, we have this, but the challenge is how do you, and this is within their mandate to be able to account.